There were four of us. George and William Samuel Harris and myself and Montmorency. We were sitting in my room, smoking and talking about how bad we were. Bad from a medical point of view, I mean, of course. We were all feeling seedy. With me, it was my liver that was out of order. I knew it was my liver that was out of order because I had just been reading a patent liver pill circular in which were detailed various symptoms by which a man could tell when his liver was out of order. I had them all. It is a most extraordinary thing. I remember going to the British Museum one day to read up the treatment for some slight ailment of which I had a touch. Hay fever, I fancy it was. I got down the book and read all I came to read. And then, in an unthinking moment, I idly turned the leaves and began to indolently study diseases generally. I forget which was the first distemper I plunged into, some fearful, devastating scourge, I know. And before I had glanced half down the list of premonitory symptoms, it was borne in upon me that I had fairly got it. I sat for a while frozen with horror. And then, in the listlessness of despair, I again turned over the pages. I came to typhoid fever, read the symptoms, discovered that I had typhoid fever, must have had it for months without knowing it, wondered what else I had got, turned up St. Vitus's dance, found, as I expected, that I had that too, began to get interested in my case and determined to sift it to the bottom, and so started alphabetically. Read up ague, learned that I was sickening for it and that the acute stage would commence in about another fortnight. Bright's disease I was relieved to find I had only in modified form, and so far as that was concerned, I might live for years. Cholera I had, with severe complications, and diphtheria I seemed to have been born with. I plodded conscientiously through the 26 letters, and the only malady I could conclude I had not got was housemaid's knee.